Did you know that there's an ad format called LinkedIn Lead Gen Form Ads? Stick around and we'll show you exactly how to use them and create them. You may have heard that LinkedIn ads are really expensive, so it can be really important to make sure that you're doing everything possible to keep performance high and costs low. Anytime you send someone to a landing page, you're introducing a lot of steps and adding friction that can lower your overall conversion rate. So this is a great ad format to reduce that friction and get the highest conversion rates possible. And be sure to stick around to the end because I'm going to tell you the differences between lead gen form ads and sending to a landing page so you can determine which one is best for your objective. All right, let's jump in. I'm going to show you how to create these. So if you're on LinkedIn.com, come up here to the upper right and click on Advertise, or if you don't see that icon, click on Work and come down to Marketing Solutions. Then when you're on this screen, you can click Create Ad, and then it'll show you a list of all of your accounts. I've got access to several. We're actually going to be creating these inside of Social Media Examiner's ads account, just for fun. The first place that it dumps you is here on campaign groups. So click into whichever campaign group that you want. Right now we just have the default that comes with every account. Now we're going to create a campaign. Lead gen form ads can work on either sponsored in-mail or sponsored content ads. So we'll create this like sponsored content, just as an example. For objective, we have to come here to lead generation. Next, we get to select our audience. And because we know that Social Media Examiner's audience are social media marketers, what I want to do is come here to audience attributes, select job experience, member skills. I'm going to type social media and see what's available here. So social media marketing is great, social media optimization, social media advertising, social media measurement. These are all great skills. This creates an audience size that is quite large, and I really like audiences between about 20,000 to 80,000, but this works as a good example. I'm always going to uncheck this box that LinkedIn includes by default called Enable Audience Expansion. I don't want LinkedIn to muddy my audience with anything. I want them to just take exactly what we've given them. Then when we choose our ad format here, we can choose a single image ad, which we're going to do, but you can also do carousels where you have multiple images in the same ad, a video sponsored content, or messaging ad as sponsored in mail. Let's start with single image ad. As you scroll down here to the budget and schedule options, what I recommend is changing immediately your bid type from automated bid to cost per click or CPC. There's a lot to go over here in the budgeting section, so make sure to check out the link in the description for where we go into a lot of depth about bidding and budgeting. I'm unchecking the box here for lead optimization because I don't want LinkedIn making the decision about who is more likely to convert than someone else. I want a level baseline. And then I'm coming here to the bid amount. If I'm on a really limited budget, what I'm going to do is set a bid amount that is way too low, like $2. And LinkedIn's gonna come back to me in red and say, your bid needs to be at least X. If I set my bid to that amount, and I'm able to spend my entire budget, then I know I just got the lowest cost per click and lowest cost per lead possible on LinkedIn. I love that approach to start out with. If you're not getting enough traffic, you can always come and increase it. Now, before I leave this screen, I'm gonna make sure to give my campaign a meaningful name so I can understand what my account is doing at a glance. My favorite way to name campaigns is to name them after the ad format that I'm using, the objective, and the audience. And think of this like something evergreen, that this campaign's gonna be active for a long time. In this case, because I'm using sponsored content, I'll start with SC, and then I'll do a separator and show my objective. I'll use LGF for lead gen forms. Then I wanna describe this audience, and I'll do SMM skills for social media marketing skills in the US. That's a pretty good description of who this audience is and how we're targeting them and why. Then when we hit next, it'll take us to where we actually get to create the ad itself. We don't have any ads in this campaign, so I'm gonna create a new ad here. With sponsored content, your ad name field is optional, but I like to put the date that I'm launching the ad or something that would help me understand how this ad is different from others. I'm gonna pop down first to the destination URL field. As I put in my landing page URL, it's going to autofill my headline and my description from the landing page itself. The headline is pulled from your SEO page title, and the description is actually your meta description on the page. But it's interesting to note that this description never shows up. So you could put whatever you want here or delete it. It literally doesn't matter. For the intro text, this is the most important text of the whole thing, and we're going to talk about why it's a great idea to come to Social Media Marketing World in 2020. Social media marketers, listen up. Social Media Marketing World is the one event you need to attend this year. Register now. Then I'm going to come down here to the headline portion. So on the headline, I really like to explain what type of offer or asset someone's getting. I generally put that in square brackets. So here we have top social media conference. This is what you're getting. And then I give it the name, Social Media Marketing World 2020. Like I mentioned, description literally doesn't matter what you have here. No one will ever see it. If you like the image that it pulled from your website directly, then you can keep it. Otherwise, and we actually have an asset for this, I'm going to hit the X here and upload a new image. And I happen to have an image that's already exactly the right size, 1200 by 627. So as I upload it, you can see uploading, and then the ad here will change to the right asset. And for you Facebook ads experts, don't worry, we don't have anything like the 20% text rule. You can put whatever you want in that image as long as it's not offensive. Next, you'll want to come down here to form details. This is where we actually get to create the form that drops down from the ad so someone can fill it out right there. For the call to action, we can choose any of the standard ones here. Because this is a conference, I might do something like learn more. We're creating a brand new form, so I'll leave this as create new, but if you've ever created a form before that you just want to use the same one, you can do that here and bring it in. This is where you name the form, and so we'll call this one like Social Media Marketing World 20. Select your language. For the headline here, they've already seen our original ad copy, so I just want one more nail in the coffin to let them know this is really what you want to do. So I'll throw on here, join thousands of social media marketers in March. Then here under details, add anything that would help strengthen your value proposition so that someone would want to convert. I put in here the best social media marketers and speakers in one place, gain actionable tips from more than 100 of the world's top social media pros. Next, you'll want to put the privacy policy URL, and this is required. Make sure that your website actually has a privacy policy and input it here. For the privacy policy text down here, maybe your internal counsel or lawyer has something you want to put there, but you don't have to. Next, we come to lead details and custom questions. This is where you get to choose what fields go in the form. If you choose any options here that LinkedIn knows, they will autofill it, making it really easy for someone just to hit autofill and submit. The email address that LinkedIn includes by default is their login email address, which is oftentimes a personal. So if you want to force them giving you their work email address, remove email, come to contact, and include work email. That will provide a little bit of extra friction because they'll have to actually fill out this field that hasn't been all auto-filled or pre-filled. If you need anything else, any other questions or checkboxes, maybe your sales team needs, then you can add custom questions or custom checkboxes here that get passed through the form. We don't need any of that. We just want first name, last name, and work email. So I'll come here to confirmation. This is where you get to include your message about like, hey, thanks, we're going to get back to you, or we'll send you some information, or someone's gonna call you. I really like using the landing page URL field here because if someone is only on LinkedIn and they fill out this form and they've never been to your website, your other channels can't do any sort of retargeting or nurture around them. I love dumping them on a landing page where you can track and control. Here, I might actually put a landing page URL that is a thank you page on my website. So here for message, I'm just gonna put, thanks for reaching out. We'll send you details about Social Media Marketing World in your inbox now. We send them to that landing page URL, and the thank you message call to action, we can say, maybe learn more. Then if your CRM requires hidden fields to come through, you can click here on hidden fields, and you could add something like source, medium, campaign, content, something along those lines. But because I already included UTM parameters in my confirmation URL, I'm not gonna worry about this right now. All right, so I'll click create. So now you can see this ad has been created, and the lead gen form that it's attached to has also been created. So if we click the next button here, we can click launch campaign. Now I'm going to go back to the account overview here. Once you hit launch campaign, it will send it live. So if you're not ready for it to run yet, just come back here to the dashboard and flip this from active to paused. But now you have a campaign with a lead generation form that's actually running. The next really important piece for you to understand is that once leads are going to LinkedIn, you need to find a way to get them out. So here's what you're gonna wanna do about that. Come here over to Account Assets and Lead Gen Forms. This form hasn't had any leads yet, but if it had, I can click here on Actions and Download Leads. And that would give me a CSV file with all of the information that I've requested. But if you do this, you as the marketer are going to have to go in every single day and download this sheet and do something with it. If you want to pass your leads into another system, what you'll want to use are one of LinkedIn's integrations. LinkedIn's integration partners like Salesforce, HubSpot, Eloqua, Marketo, LiveRamp, and a few others, you will actually go into that platform and integrate directly with LinkedIn. If you don't happen to have one of those integration partners, what you can use is Zapier.com. Zapier has, for their $20 a month plan, the ability to integrate with lead gen forms on LinkedIn and pass those leads to about any system you can imagine. So with all of the benefits of lead gen form ads, that still might not be the best way for you to generate leads. As promised, let's walk through the pros and cons of using these. LinkedIn makes it so easy for people to become a lead here. They've pre-filled all of these fields and all they have to do is hit submit. Sometimes you'll have lead quality issues where someone doesn't even remember filling out the form. So if your goal is really to make a strong impression on someone with your brand, maybe they're a high value prospect to you and you want to make sure that you guys are doing business in the future and signing big deals, then you may want to send them to your landing page instead. But lead gen form ads are so good at converting people. If your goal is just to get as many names of your target audience in your database for nurture, it's by far the best way to do it. One way we really like to use lead gen forms is actually to test if our landing page is getting in the way of conversion. If we have the same offer that we're pitching on the landing page and we pitch it through a lead gen form where we're skipping the landing page, if our conversion rates are significantly different between those two, then we know the only difference is the way we presented things on the landing page. So it's a good crack test you can run just to see if your landing page is in the way. When you send traffic to your landing page, you can then retarget that traffic through Facebook and Google, any other channel you're running retargeting on, which is very powerful. You can also track that traffic with UTM parameters or other tracking parameters in your URLs that you wouldn't be able to do if you were running all of your traffic through the lead gen forms on LinkedIn. So test it out and see if this is going to be the best way for you to generate leads or if you want to send to landing page instead. So depending on which ad format you want to create these lead gen form ads with, either sponsored content or messaging ads, click on the playlist on your screen to go and see how to create those in depth.